What's something that you're looking to accomplish over the next 12 months?
In the next 12 months, I would like to be able to double my sales. Definitely. Yeah, that's really my one goal right there. It's just to double my sales.
What do you think that you would need to do or put in place in order to help you do that?
Hire an assistant. Yeah. Did you see there was no hesitation there? Hire an assistant.
You know, I find sometimes, like, you know, a lot of times agents are so scared to take that next step. Right. I did a coaching call earlier this week, and you know, the agent does about 30 to 40 deals on average per year. And it was the same questions, like, do you believe I'm ready? And a lot of times as agents, you're never ready, right? But by you not making the decision to do it is actually the thing that's holding you back. Whereas, and I told the agent this, there may be times where that assistant isn't busy. Well, guess what? That should motivate you to then go make them busy because you're paying them, right? And in right. theory, and in theory, that assistant is going to free up a lot of your time to allow you to stay on those activities that will really drive the business forward.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
What are you looking to accomplish in the next 5 years?
Oh my goodness. I'm not even sure if I've thought about it that far out. I know on a personal level, I'm saving to buy a condo. So that's on my list there. But just keep working on my business, on myself. You know, we can always strive to improve ourselves every day. You know, I feel like every day is a fresh start. You can start over. You know, if you had a bad day yesterday and a bad transaction or whatever, okay, today's a new day, and, you know, clean yeah. sleep.
No, I've had this conversation this year quite a few times, and it's, you know, and you know this, 1 month can really change the trajectory of your year, right? You may have a bad year up to a certain point, but, you know, if you just stayed laser focused and locked in, you know, in our industry, there's no cap on what we can make, you know, every single month. And, you know, that 1 month could get you back on track. And one of the agents that I coach, you know, he had a life event happen, like his first baby was born at the beginning of the year. And, you know, it really took him off of his rhythm, right? Because now you got the baby crying and stuff. And, you know, he went from two deals through the first 6 months to now he has six in contract right now, right? And it's just, you know, that's the great thing about this business is you can really change it around in 30 to 60 days if you want.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Yeah.
Cindy, what is a legacy goal for you? What is a goal that you're looking to hit when you're no longer here?
Oh my God.
We're getting deep now.
Well, that wasn't on the list of questions you sent me. Oh my goodness.
It's hard because I think in our business, we don't get asked that a lot, right? Like, I think it's always typical, hey, what's your 1 year goal? What's your 5 year goal? What's your 10 year goal? Right. But, you know, what is that? The way I look at this is like, what is that thing that you're always going to be chasing? Right. Like, you may never accomplish it. You may accomplish it. But what's that thing that's going to keep pulling you through when times get tough? And what's that impact that you want to have? You know, and it may not be real estate related, right? It may just be, you know, family or life or whatever the case may be. But I feel like that's an important question because I don't think that we actually put a lot of thought into it.
Yeah. I just, I don't know. I guess just being able to have the time to spend with my friends, my family. And, you know, the nice thing about this career is that, you know, there are oftentimes we can just pick up and go when we need to. Yeah, my family means so much to me, and we're a little spread apart now, so it makes it difficult.
Yeah.
And that's just on my mind right now because I'm going to be going to see my son and my grandkids in Massachusetts on Sunday.
There you
So,
go. There
yeah.
you go.
Yeah.
No, I love it. I love it. I think, like I said, I think it was a question that was asked to me last year by a friend who read that in a book. So I always throw it into these because I think it's important for us as small business owners, because there are the lows and those moments of time of like, what's that thing that I really need to go after and chase, right? What's that? I call it the North Star. What's that North Star that I need to always be looking for? So.